Hey guys, I'm Venkat, and in this video, we'll discuss how to become a full-stack web developer without spending a penny out of your pocket. All the information, video tutorials, and complete course material is available online at your fingertips. All you truly need is an internet connection, of course, your willingness and time to learn as well. Whether you just graduated and looking for your first job, or you already have some experience and in the market looking for a change of job, I'm sure you're asked the following question: are you a full stack web developer or are you a full stack software engineer? So who is a full stack web developer? Before we understand this, let's understand the three main parts of an enterprise class data-driven web application. Here we go. These are the three main parts: front-end, back-end, and database. These days, for front-end web development, most companies use frameworks like Angular, React, Vue, etc. For back-end, that is server-side web development, we usually use frameworks like ASP.NET Core, Java, etc. For storing data, we need a relational or a non-relational database. However, keep in mind, most of the enterprise class data-driven web applications that are built these days use both a relational and a non-relational database. Examples of relational databases are Microsoft SQL Server, Oracle, MySQL, etc. And examples of non-relational databases are MongoDB, DocumentDB, Cassandra, etc. These non-relational databases are also called NoSQL databases. So at the very least, for you to be a full stack web developer, you need to learn at least one technology from each of these three main areas of web development, that is front-end, back-end, and database. Now, before full stack web development became so popular, we had specialized roles like front-end developers, back-end developers, and database developers. As the roles clearly imply, a front-end developer is only responsible for the front-end area of the system. That is, he works just on the front-end development of the system. Similarly, a back-end developer only on the back-end, and a database developer only on the database. Gone are those days. In the software development domain, full-stack developer has become one of the most sought-after positions these days. Now, I'm a .NET full-stack web developer. So let me take you through the skills that you should learn to become a .NET full-stack web developer. I suggest the following courses in the order specified. Start with backend. So first C#, followed by that SQL Server, and then Entity Framework, Link, ASP.NET Web API, and ASP.NET Core. And then let's move on to the front-end. Start with the basics of JavaScript. Finally, Angular 2 and above. These are essential skills. We have all these courses available on our website at no cost to you. I'll have the links to all these courses in the order specified in the description of this video, so you can start learning them. As I said before, these are essential skills. So after you finish learning these courses, I suggest learn these courses as well, because these are nice to have skills: design patterns, solid design principles, razor pages, a non-relational database like MongoDB, for example, and then a source control system like TFS, that is Team Foundation Server, or Git. To start learning these courses, you need to have basic knowledge of HTML and CSS. All you need are the basics. You don't have to be an expert. There are many free resources on the internet to get up to speed with basics of HTML and CSS. I would say maybe spend 4 hours on HTML and maybe another 4 hours on CSS. Now, as far as Angular is concerned, there are many courses on our website. So I suggest the following learning path for Angular. As you might already know, there is a massive difference between AngularJS 1 and Angular 2. If you know you'll be working and supporting AngularJS 1 applications, only then I suggest learning AngularJS 1. As you know, AngularJS 1 is obsolete. If you know you won't be supporting AngularJS 1 applications, I suggest start with Angular 2. There's no much difference between Angular 2, 4, 5, 6, 8, and even future versions. The way we build Angular applications using these versions, that is Angular 2, 4, 5, 6, 8, or even future versions, is very identical. If you're starting to learn Angular, I suggest start with Angular 2. We have discussed all the Angular basics in this Angular 2 course. These basics are the same for Angular versions like 2, 4, 5, 6, 8, and even future versions. Once you are comfortable with Angular basics, please learn Angular CLI. I believe every Angular developer should learn how to use this powerful tool, Angular CLI. It greatly increases your productivity while still following Angular's best practices and conventions. And then Angular CRUD tutorial. This tutorial uses Angular 5 and covers all the concepts you are not able to cover in Angular 2 course. Finally, start Angular 6 course. In this course, we've covered important advanced Angular concepts we were not able to cover in Angular 2 and Angular CRUD courses. Hope you'll find these resources useful to learn Angular. If you're confident with the concepts discussed in these courses, you will easily find a job as a .NET full-stack software engineer, and you can also compete and work alongside people with even over 10 years of experience. As I said before, all these courses are available on our website at no additional cost to you. All you need is an internet connection and the willingness to learn. Everything is out there on the internet, free of cost, at your fingertips. Now, all the courses that we have just seen on the slide are available on our website, prajimtech.com. So click on Courses and then Free Online Courses. On this page, you'll find all those courses. For example, if you want to learn ASP.NET Core, click on the ASP.NET Core MVC course right here. And on this course page, we have all the ASP.NET Core videos, text articles, and slides in sequence. Every course page also has reviews tab. Remember, your feedback is really important to me. So if you have a couple of minutes, please provide your rating for the course and valuable feedback. Wish you all the best, and I hope you'll find a great job soon as a full-stack .NET developer. Happy coding. Goodbye for now.